Hello, I'm Mr. R. Najjar, a retired lecturer of Matadri, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I give you a discourse on why Christ Jesus came into this world. And he came into this world because the rabbi had become greedy, had started to love mammon, and they started to corrupt the scripture. And as Jesus said, the old cloth has dwelt holes. So when this corrupted and everything system, they start cheating people in the name of God, then God sends his own priest to look after them. So Christ Jesus came to look after the devotees of God, such as the widow who puts her mite into the temple treasury. So such devoted people, to look after them, to prevent them from being fleeced by these hypocrites, Christ Jesus come to disclose their hypocrisy, to expose them. And this is exposed by, in the name of his word, not that you just call them here this and that, but you should give the principle. And it's very easy if you can think logically. So light of God you only get when you are 100% devoted to God and no dependence on mammon at all. Thus, in order to become a rabbi, you remember the rabbinic post was a hereditary. It was not that anybody could become. So when the father died, then the son used to take it over. The men would leave their family, so when they want to take the post of a rabbi, the men would leave their family homes and take up the rabbinic post in a far away village, so that there is no contact with his family. So the rabbi is to be supposed to be 100% devoted to the work of God, as John the Baptist was. He was not married. He took to wilderness and he left his family home. That's how they used to be. And the rabbi, as you can know, these are Jewish laws and Jewish people, that a person who is doing the job of the rabbi, he is not allowed to own immovable property. He is not allowed to have land, or to take the land or anything. He should be like a floating medium. So as if he owns nothing in this world, so that he is fully devoted to the service of God. It was like to be as if the person has died. So they used to leave their family homes and to go to the other village to take up the position, so that no family worries. It was like to be as if the person or the person has died, leaving behind all his relations, property, etc. Devote rabbis would offer their own blood sacrifice instead of the bull or other animal at Passover. For rabbis, keeping law and order that creates heavenly atmosphere in the village, Christ Jesus said, the keys to the kingdom of heaven was given to the rabbis, but when they became greedy and corrupt, then they would neither enter themselves into the kingdom of heaven, nor let anyone else enter into it. So then when they became greedy, then there was no law and order, they start doing favors to people. When they do favors, which is against the God. In God, you have to be impartial and righteous person. So as soon as you do favor, you become son of Satan, which we call bastard. Because God doesn't want to know people who do favor to other. They should be impartial like little children. So you are either son of God, are you sons of Satan? There are many sons of Satan in this world now. Christ Jesus in his saying, stresses relinquishing one's secular identity and life. Some became eunuchs for the kingdom of heaven is mentioned in Matthew 19. So that's what he meant by becoming eunuch, that you leave your family as if you are not married. Rabbis received their education in the written Torah, the scriptures, and the oral Torah, the word of God, or gospel, that cannot be written down in ink on paper from an enlightened rabbi. But as the rabbis became greedy, corrupt, and hypocrites, then the understanding of the oral Torah was taken away from them, and they were plying the dead letters of scriptures for their living, or for their fleecing people, as they do today. Moral laws are written Torah, could be visualized as the tree of life bearing fruit with roots in oral Torah or gospel. So oral Torah is the one which supply the sporting juice or water to the tree, which is displaying outside. So the leaves of the tree are the moral laws. The disciples of rabbis were the fruit known by their rabbis. So the people of the certain disciple of the rabbis, the behavior of them is known by through what type of rabbi they have. If the rabbi is honest, then the fruit is honest. As in John 4, the Samaritan woman at the well. These people, Samaritans, they honored their Levi priest. And the result was that he produced excellent fruit, that Jesus was so pleased with it. And that's why Jesus said, somebody else sowed and somebody else came to reap it. The sowing was done by their village rabbi, and Christ Jesus came to reap the fruit. So this Samaritan woman became Saint Fortina. And these are blind to spirit university lecturer, they call her, that she was a prostitute, marrying one husband after the other. There were five spiritual temptations which she had overpowered. The disciples, rabbis have disciples. The disciples of rabbis were the fruit known by their rabbi, quality of the rabbi. Rabbi used to coin moral laws at the holiest of holy temple, which Christ Jesus described as the wine press producing old wine. Old wine is the scriptures in the light of a gospel, when they were had the knowledge of oral Torah. But as they became corrupt, the owner, God, sent many messengers to tell them to produce good quality wine. But they loved mammon so much that they maltreated and killed them. Remember the parable? Then owner sent his very son, Christ Jesus, that on knowing him, they would honor him and treat him with respect, with honor. But they became hostile to him as well and killed him too. Then what would you expect of Father God? He took the wine press away from them and gave it to others. So this holiest of holy temple in Jerusalem that was destroyed in 70 AD now exists in Amritsar, known as the Golden Temple. It is far more corrupt than what it used to be in Jerusalem. Tell me what gold has to do with God. More on this subject is presented in my videos on Sikhism. Those rabbis caused utter darkness, hypocrisy. So Christ came and to fight the